Guys, what is it doing? Wow. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki, I'm 43, from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And say hello to Miss Muffet, in case you are new. If you are a returning subscriber, yeah, you know she's in the holiday spirit with her nice Santa hat. I think it's kinda maybe a bit broken. I don't know what's happening, people, but yeah, there's that. Maybe she's a bit tired of all the festivities. I don't know. Anyway, last year I made a list of brands I wanted to try this year, and today I'm going to go over the list and see if I have tried them, and yeah, if they were as good as I thought they were, basically. So yeah, there were only 5 on the list. I will link the video that I did last year down in the description box. Let's just get into it. Oh, before I forget, the look I have, I did film. It is online on my channel. It is a chatty get ready with me, very chatty. I was very chatty in that video. And I did it with the Odin's Eye Freya palette. So Odin's Eye is the company. Freya is the name of the palette. I have it here. This is what she looks like. And here's the inside. She gorgeous. She really, really pretty. Just saying. This is one of those indie brands that is not talked about and should be, but definitely worth checking out. I will leave their website down in my description box. Okay, yeah, the rest of the makeup will also be down there. Let's just get into the list because, yes, that's it. So I had 5 brands on my list and I hope I won't ramble too much so that we can kind of hurry it up a little bit. Let's get on with the first brand. And the first brand was ColourPop. I did try ColourPop. I have some things here. I have 3 of their monochromatic palettes. I also have the Good Sport. I have some BFF mascaras. And I have some some eye pencils. I also tried a blotted lip. The formula I really liked, but I did not like the color, so I gave it away. The eye pencils, yeah, they're nice. I have here still 3 colors. I have the purple, the orange, and the green. The green I need to toss because it is dried out already. Same happened with the yellow one, the punch, or in color punch. It dried out really, really quickly. So those 2 shades are, in my opinion, not good. These 2 are very nice. They are still good. So I don't know if it is difficult to fabricate yellows and maybe lighter greens. I have no idea. However, I have a light green that I got from AliExpress. That's really nice. I also have a light green from Essence that is about 1.5 years old. That is still going strong. So yeah. So when I kind of got the It's My Pleasure palette, I bought it myself, along with the BFFs and a pencil. Yeah, so that was it. This one, it's a nice quality. It's a very nice quality. But it was not as good as I thought it would be. Does that make any sense? I actually thought it would be better than Juvia's Place, because that is the feeling that I got when I heard people talk about ColourPop. So there's that. Also, I think they let ColourPop get away with a lot because it is so affordable. It really
annoys me when people say that.
I get it, but still, especially because, for instance, the Sweet and Tasty collection that I have from iHeart Revolution is really good. Also, Makeup Obsession, the eyeshadows in the cardboard palettes. Such a good formula. And that is cheaper than ColourPop. So, you know, I think that's it. I tried ColourPop. I like it. I don't really get excited about them anymore. Just because, yeah, it's basically not that affordable for me to get. And while I think the quality is nice, I am not in a hurry to basically make a big ColourPop order if I can get Makeup Revolution here way easier. And yeah, the quality sometimes is even better. So I hope that makes sense. But yeah, that's it. Okay. The next one that is on my list was Hourglass. And then specifically the ambient lighting powders and the Veal translucent setting powder. I have here the Veal because one of you gifted this to me, and when I saw that, I almost cried. That is how much I wanted to try this powder, but it is so, so expensive, and I was so afraid that if I would buy it, I wouldn't like it. So I never bought it. And then one of you sent it to me, and it is so good. And I am so mad about it that it is so good. Because when I run out, I want to repurchase, but it is 50 freaking euros. It's so fucking expensive. It is insane. I did check if I saw a sale during Black Friday, and I did see the Laura Mercier powder on sale, but I didn't saw the Hourglass powder. And to be quite honest with you, now when I'm in winter time, I gravitate more towards pressed powders to set my face anyway, because I over powder with loose powder and then it looks not nice. Or maybe, well, this makes everything look nice, but it doesn't feel nice. It feels too powdery and too drying. And I don't want to waste this, you know, because, yeah, I love this so much. The ambient light powder, I don't need anymore. Sure, I would love to try it, but I think I have a very, very good dupe for it. And that is my Revolution Pro Skin Finish that I have on my face today. I even have it on as a highlighter because I also use it with a denser brush and then as a highlighter. It's so pretty, and then especially combined with a pressed powder that I use to set my face with, then dust that over. It's just so pretty. I don't have a cake face then. So yeah, I don't need the ambient lighting powder anymore. It is still, of course it's still on my wish list, but I think that when I try it, maybe I will see if I can get hold of a mini that I can compare it to my Revolution one. But yeah, it's still of course still on my wish list, but not high anymore. So there's that. But this puppy, oh lord, so good. I'm still hoping to find a dupe. I can kinda get the same effect a little bit with my skin finish, but yeah, it is not the same. This is way, way prettier. Just saying. Okay, let's go to the next one, which is a Jeffree Star. And when I did the video last year, I had one liquid lipstick from him. It was a light purple one in, I think it's Self Control. Let me check. Yeah, it was the color Self Control. I was also just starting wearing... Is that good English? I was just starting to wear liquid lipsticks. That's the correct sentence. And it was one of the first liquid lipstick formulas that I tried. It's not a bad formula. It's not my favorite anymore though. In that video I said it was my favorite formula. It's not. It's nice. It doesn't dry out my lips. However, the light purple one, and I have one in a very, very pale nude, those skip. I did find though that if I relax my mouth and then apply it, it skips less, but it still kind of skips. So that's pretty annoying. But yeah, so it's nice. Not my favorite, but it's nice. And in case you want to know my favorite lipstick, liquid lipstick formulas are the Generation Matte from Catrice. And I need to show them to you because there are two kinds. I mean the one in this tube. The Comfort Matte. This is so, so good. I have one on today. Very, very good. And I really love the L'Oreal Rouge Signature. That's a very light formula. Perfect. So yeah, there's that. So those are my two favorite liquid lipstick formulas. At the moment, at least. But yeah. So I wanted to try more of his lippies. He has a very unique color range. And since then I have discovered more brands that have a unique color range in liquid lipsticks. So yeah, I'm very happy about that. I also wanted to try his eyeshadow formula, specifically the Alien palette. And when I finally got a hold of that, I was so, so happy. And it is still one of my favorite eyeshadow palettes. I love the color story. The color story is pretty unique. And yeah, I love it. I love the formula as well. I think the formula is great. Some shades stain like a mother effer though. So yeah, there's that. And since then, I have the Alien, I have the Blue Blood, I have both Jawbreaker palettes. That's it. Alien, Jawbreaker, Blue Blood. Yeah. So those are the palettes that I have from Jeffree Star. My favorites are the Alien and the Mini Breaker. Those two are my favorites. And yeah, his shimmer quality is so, so nice. She stains. Very, very much. But it's a very, very pretty shimmer formula. His mattes, some are amazing. Some are, yeah, okay. And some are just not really that good. Let's just say that. But you know, I do really like his eye for color and for kind of the weird color combinations. And I would actually love to brainstorm with him about color combinations in an eyeshadow palette, because yeah, I would just love that. And that is one of the reasons that I love the Shane documentary so much, because I could really see how he picks his shadows and I could almost see his mind working. Because you don't have to like him as a person, he's just a brilliant businessman, just saying, you know. Okay, so there is that. So that was Jeffree Star, and yeah, I am sure I will try more of him in the future. Okay, the next one is Ace Beauty. Beauty? I usually say Ace Beauty, but I think it's Ace Beauty. And I love them. I have here the Complete Paradise collection that was a present as well. And I still have the PR box as well. I won't throw it out, but I have the Complete Paradise collection. I also have the Oceanic palette and the Flare palette. And they just released two new palettes, the Scarlet Dusk and the Vintage Dawn, if I'm not mistaken. They look very, very pretty. But as I'm filming this, Black Friday has just come and gone, and I have 5 palettes coming in. Let me just say this, if they come to Boosie Shop, because Boosie Shop, that's based in the Netherlands but ships internationally, carries Ace Beauty as well. And that's where I got the Oceanic and the Flare from. If they come there, I think I will pick them up. Yeah, because the formula, so good. So good. I do have to be honest and say that I think that the shimmer formula in the Paradise collection, it's different than in the Flare and the Oceanic. Some of the shimmers in the Flare and the Oceanic are a little bit of those, I don't know, those glittery ones that give massive amount of fallout. They're pretty, but they give massive amount of fallout. And while I really love both palettes, it is not my favorite, most loved shimmer formula. They're pretty, but I prefer a little bit of a creamier shimmer formula. But that's just me personally. I love all the palettes to death. But yeah, that was it. And yeah, Ace Beauty is just one of my favorite brands. So yeah, I'm very, very happy that I got to try them this year. The last brand, how long have I been filming for you? Okay. The last brand that I had on my list is Sigil. Sigil is a Russian-based indie brand, and she is known for her loose multi-chromes. I have still not tried Sigil. I still want to try Sigil. But she has so many gorgeous things that I just don't know what to pick. And unfortunately, my budget is not sufficient to just go ahead and pick out, I don't know, 10 shades from her site or something like that. So yeah, I still want to try her. I just still don't know what, basically. So yeah, I think that's it, guys. Yeah, let me know down below if you had a list of brands to try for this year, and if you tried some, and if they lived up to your expectations. So yeah, that was it. I still need to film my list for 2020, which are more brands. Because yeah, this is my second... We are going... This is my second year, isn't it? Yeah. So, I started my channel last year in... I think it was the spring. So, I'm now a year and a half really immersed in the beauty community and really, you know, getting to know brands and seeing what they come out with and doing my own Let's Talk makeup videos, that my list is longer for next year. So yeah, there's that. If you want to know my list for next year, hit the subscribe button if you haven't done so already, and then also hit the bell so you will be notified when said video will go live. And that is it for me. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. It will help me out tremendously. It will let YouTube know that you like me and Miss Muffet, and that we need to be spread around all over the internet. So yeah, there's that. I'm going to sign off. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Thank you so, so much for watching. I want to wish you a fantastic day, fabulous evening, and I will see you really, really soon in my next one. Bye, guys.